Hello everyone. So in this video we'll be seeing about control system. So previous video we saw about what is a system, what are the types of system, and what is measurement system. So with an example we saw about what is a measurement system. Now here we'll be seeing about control system. So this is also one of the classification of a system which manages, commands and directs and regulates the behavior of a devices using a control loops. So it uses some loops to control the system, entire system. It can range from a single home heating controller using a thermostat controlling a domestic boiler to a large industrial control system which are used for controlling process or machines. So there are wide variety of control systems available which ranges from a household purpose to a very big industrial purpose. So this is a simple diagram of a control unit where there is a set point, that is here the input is obtained. There is a control unit along with the actuator and the process takes place, and there is a sensor, and after the process is completed the controlled output is given. So this is a simple block diagram showing about the control system. So there are three requirements of a control system. One is stability, accuracy and response. So stability, for any change in the input signal, the output system or output of the system reads or makes it response at a reasonable value. So that is stability. The next one is accuracy, the closeness of the result. So if we giving an input as 99, the output what we are obtained should be also of 99. If it is 8.9 also, it is not accepted as an output. So for example, we can take an AC, air conditioner. So we will set the temperature. For example, if we are setting the temperature as 18 degree, input we are giving as 18 degree. What should be the output? The output also should be of 18 degree. So if it is not obtained, then there is something problem in the process. So again the process repeats. So this process repeats until we get the temperature as 18, output temperature as 18. So whatever the input we are giving in a control system, the same thing should be obtained as an output. So this is the control system, and the stability, accuracy and response. The quickness, it should respond quickly. So that is also one of the most basic requirement of a control system. The next one is about types of control system. There are two types of control system. So previously in the introduction we saw like the control system, it works on the loop. So the classification is also given based on the loop. One is open loop control system, the other one is closed loop control system. Now let's have a look into what is open loop control system. So as the name suggests, it is a open one. So we are giving some input, some process takes place and some output we are getting, but we don't know whether it is accurate and exact result is obtained. For example, we are placing some consider agriculture field. We are placing some paddy, some plants in the field. We are just placing, that's the example of open. What control action we are doing? We are just placing the plant, but we don't know whether accurately and exact. We have just placed it, we know the work is done, but we don't know whether it is accurately done. So that type of work is called as a open loop control system. So in an open loop control system, the work is done. And if you take our machine shop also, in the lathe, we are placing the workpiece and we are doing some operations in the lathe. But we know that we have done the operation, but we don't know like to what extent it is very accurate. After measuring only we will come to know. By looking itself we cannot know that whether it is a accurate thing or not, but some work is done. So this open loop controller, the controlling action is done, but we don't know whether it is exactly done or not. So we do not have an feedback device to get whether the work is done properly or not. So This is one of example of a open loop control system, a washing machine and traffic signals. So that any control system that operates on time basis or of open loop. So here the washing machine also, it works on a time basis. We know that the process is completed, but we exactly don't know, like we will be setting the temperature of 30, but we cannot see whether the only the 30 is obtained or all the spins are done. We cannot keep on counting. So we have done some, we are given some instructions, the work is going on, but we don't know like whether the work is exactly done or not. So the next one is about traffic signals. So the traffic signal also, the signal is obtained. Okay, so anything, any control system that operates on the basis of time, it is of open loop. Next one is about closed loop control system. So closed loop control system, in open loop control system, we are just doing the work, we don't know whether it is right or not. So to overcome that, the next classification is closed loop control system, where there will be a comparison element along with all the components. There will be a comparison element and there will be a feedback signal also. So why do we need this feedback? So in the classes itself, for every semester we will be collecting feedback. So what is the purpose of that? We will be getting the feedback and we will know, come to know that what is the thing that is deviating the process, what is going in a wrong way. So all these things, by your feedback we'll come to know that what are the things happening in the classroom, like everything. So once after getting the feedback, we can rectify it. Likewise here also, there is a feedback device. It check, it monitors the entire process, and if anything is going wrong, it intimates to the comparison element. So it compares, it rectifies the error in that, and again the process it takes place. So once the input is given, all the conversions, after all the conversions and everything, some process is done. So if the output needed is not same as that of the given input, it compares with that and again it repeats. So this feedback signal, it gives a feedback about the error, and this comparison element, this is also an error detector. It rectifies the, it compares the, like what is the wrong in that output, and if it is huge, it repeats the process. So this process will be repeated until the input is same as that of a output. So we are given some required temperature, we are switching on the switch. After the output should be of a constant temperature, and if there is any deviation, the feedback signal is given to the comparison element. Once again the process is repeated. So this is about the closed loop control system. So the next one is feedback control. So what's the purpose of this feedback? What, whenever a given in a control system, whenever an input is given, it should be similar to that of the output, and when there is deviation, the feedback signal, it indicates to the error detector. The error detector, it compares the input and the obtained output. So when there is deviation, again the process repeats. So this is the purpose of a feedback control unit. So here you can see an error detector, controller, a plant where the process actually takes place, and feedback elements. So once the output is not same as the input, the feedback element, it intimates the error detector and the process repeats. So this is about the feedback element. Thank you.